Ah, summertime. It's the season of cookouts, camping, swimming, and of course, dealing with pesky, creepy crawlies. Sure, the majority of them are overall harmless, even if they are annoying. But there are some truly dangerous bugs out there that you definitely don't want to find crawling on you. We'll show you what bugs you'll want to watch out for this summer. Oh, gross! Make sure to squash that bug on your screen hovering just over the subscribe button. Looks like he crawled over to the notification button too, so better press it to be safe. Kissing bug. Aw, a kissing bug sounds absolutely adorable. Well, the triatomin bug must have a good marketing department because kissing bug does sound a lot better than carrier of the dangerous Trypanosoma cruzi parasite. Each year, these parasites are responsible for 11,000 deaths worldwide. Like many other annoying bugs, they drink the blood of other creatures, but these can make a deposit of parasites when they do so. And they do so in the most unsavory way possible, by using the wound they create as a toilet. We guess nobody told these guys the phrase, "Don't crap where you eat." They get their nickname because they enjoy feeding around the lips and faces of their victims. They're nocturnal, meaning that you might not even realize you've been bitten if it happens while you're asleep. The parasites that they deposit on you can cause an infection known as Chagas disease. For the majority of people, you'll end up with flu-like symptoms such as vomiting, fever, and body aches. But for the unlucky 20 to 30% of people whose symptoms progress, they can become chronically ill and suffer from difficulty breathing, fatigue, and chest pain. And like we mentioned earlier, a small unlucky number don't survive their encounter with the kissing bug. Black widows. No, we're not talking about the next summer blockbuster featuring Scarlett Johansson's well-known Marvel character. Spiders are one of the most feared creatures on the planet, and being afraid of black widow spiders isn't a bad thing, because their venom is extremely toxic to humans. They're only about 1.5 inches long, but that just means that they're more likely to catch you by surprise. They're easy to identify by the distinctive red hourglass-shaped mark on their backs. Of course, we wouldn't recommend getting closer to get a good look at it. Although they can be dangerous to humans, they're mostly just dangerous to their fellow bugs. Male black widow spiders are often eaten by their female counterparts after mating, which kind of puts your last bad Tinder date into perspective. They're the most toxic bugs in North America, and their venom is 15 times more toxic than that of the prairie rattlesnake. It contains a neurotoxin known as latrotoxin that causes a condition known as latrodectism. The symptoms of this are pain, muscle rigidity, sweating, and vomiting. It's rarely fatal for humans, but we prefer not to take our chances. Sydney funnel web spider. If someone ever tried to convince you that your arachnophobia is illogical because spiders are more afraid of you than you are of them, we are sorry to let you know that person lied to you. Or at least their statement didn't take the Sydney funnel web spider into account. Unsurprisingly, these extremely aggressive and dangerous arachnids are found in Australia, where it seems like most of the creatures are out to get you. Unlike most spiders, these ones like to burrow under rocks or logs and line the entrances to their abodes with their silk. Once they catch something, they don't beat around the bush and they inject all of their venom in one bite and then continue to strike their victim with their huge fangs. These bites are incredibly painful and the spider will need to be forcibly removed or it will keep biting or just clamp down on you. They produce a compound known as atracotoxin, which is an ion channel inhibitor. If you're unlucky enough to be bitten by a Sydney funnel web spider, don't just try to walk off the pain. You'll need immediate medical attention or the venom can be fatal. Africanized bee. The Africanized bee should really get the number of whoever is in charge of public relations for the kissing bug because their nickname, Killer Bee, isn't that great for morale. This is actually a hybrid species of bee made by breeding African honeybees with various honeybees from Europe. In the 1950s, they were introduced to Brazil in an effort to increase honey production, but they promptly escaped and went on a murderous rampage, terrorizing the countryside. Okay, that last part isn't true, but they can be incredibly dangerous. They're much more reactive than other bees, meaning that if you accidentally agitate them, you're in for a bad time. They've been known to chase people up to a quarter of a mile, so clearly we are dealing with another creature that is not afraid of humans. Because they're smaller than European honeybees, they do carry less venom, but the fact that they sting their victims 10 times more than European honeybees kind of makes that a moot point. They've proven to be fatal to around 1,000 humans and many more animals. These bees may not go in search of humans, but if you cross their path, they certainly won't hold any punches or stingers when it comes to taking you down. Tarantula hawk. Despite its name, the tarantula hawk is neither a tarantula nor a hawk. This bizarre-looking creature is actually a type of spider wasp that feeds on tarantulas. If this creature can take down a tarantula, we're sure you can imagine that it's not one you would want to mess with. Their coloration may be beautiful and vivid, but it's actually a form of aposematism, meaning that it signals to predators that this wasp is capable of delivering a powerful sting. Their legs are covered in barbs that let them cling to their victims while sinking their stingers in. Their stingers can be up to a quarter of an inch long, and their sting is reportedly one of the most painful of all insect stings. As if that all wasn't unappealing enough, the way they propagate is just ghastly. They'll paralyze a tarantula with their venom before dragging their limp body to their nest, where they'll lay an egg in the spider's abdomen. Once the egg hatches, the new little tarantula hawk will eat its way out, taking care to avoid the vital organs in order to keep the tarantula alive as long as possible. Take a break to grab some bug spray and get ready for our trivia question. We mentioned that the tarantula hawk has one of the most painful stingers of all insects, but there is one insect whose sting is even more excruciating. Which bug earns the title of world's most painful sting? Keep watching for the answer. Tsetse fly. If you're in Africa, you might notice that some of the flies there look larger than ones located elsewhere in the world. If the flies fold their wings completely one over the other when at rest, you might just be looking at the dangerous tsetse fly. These bugs can also be identified by their long proboscis, which extends from their heads. The bite of a tsetse fly can transmit the protozoa of the Trypanosoma brucei, which causes sleeping sickness. The first stage of this devastating illness is indicated by fevers, headaches, itchiness, and painful joints, which occurs from 1 to 3 weeks after the bite. Anywhere from a few weeks to a few months later, the second stage sets in and can cause victims to become confused and disoriented and experience numbness and trouble falling asleep. Wait, so sleeping sickness makes you unable to fall asleep? That's not a very good name. Without treatment, this disease can be fatal, but thankfully there are treatments available. The tricky part is being able to identify the disease and begin medication early enough for it to be effective. There have been several epidemics of sleeping sickness, including one in Uganda in 1901. This devastating disease took the lives of over 250,000 people in Uganda. Mosquitoes. What would a video about dangerous bugs be without mosquitoes? These buzzing pests can be way more than just irritating, they can be downright dangerous. One disease transmitted by mosquitoes is the West Nile fever. The scary thing about contracting the West Nile virus is that for 80% of the afflicted, it's either asymptomatic or the symptoms are so minor they are easily brushed off. If they do occur, they can mimic the flu and cause fever, fatigue, and aches. It is rare, but occasionally it progresses into a serious neurological disorder that can be fatal. They can also carry yellow fever, which is a huge problem in some parts of the world. Due to changing climates and population density, incidents of this disease have been steadily increasing. In 2013, an epidemic resulted in 127,000 known cases of the disease and caused 45,000 people to lose their lives as a result. For a long time, it was known as one of the most dangerous of all infectious diseases. Suddenly, we feel the urge to stock up on bug spray. Bulldog ant. If you manage to avoid getting attacked by a Sydney funnel-web spider while visiting Australia, you'll also want to take a wide berth from the also-aggressive bulldog ant. They get their name because of their extreme ferocity and gameness when they attack. These ants are not afraid of humans, nor are they content to steal bites of your picnic food. They'll sting you over and over again, injecting venom with each rapid bite. Their long tooth mandibles are perfect for gripping into flesh while they sting you. No end of this insect is safe, as it can chomp on you with its teeth while it drives its stinger into you. Needless to say, these ants can cause a tremendous amount of pain, and the Guinness Book of World Records rates them as the most dangerous ant in the world. Their venom is extremely toxic and has even been fatal in some cases. It's some of the most dangerous venom possessed by any insect, and is especially potent when injected into people who are prone to allergic reactions. Most severe attacks happen when someone inadvertently disturbs a nest of bulldog ants, so it's always a good idea to keep an eye out. Southern flannel moth. No, President Trump didn't lose his hairpiece in the forest. This is what is commonly referred to as an asp caterpillar, which will someday become a southern flannel moth. These can be found in the eastern United States, Mexico, and parts of Central America. You're probably thinking that few things are less dangerous than a moth. After all, those are the insects that are constantly hurling themselves against lanterns and porch lights all summer. However, this particular moth is actually venomous when it's a caterpillar. What may resemble our president's hairdo is actually a collection of venomous spines that you do not want to come into contact with. You will immediately be in excruciating pain and your skin will erupt into an angry red welt. It's so powerful that people have likened the experience to breaking a bone or undergoing severe blunt force trauma. In addition, you can expect nausea, headaches, blisters, and even chest pain and difficulty breathing in some severe cases. We know it can be tempting to get fluffy-looking things, but this is one creature that you definitely don't want to come into contact with. Lone Star Tick. Few things make us want to run screaming into the night than finding a tick on us. Not that running is useful in such a scenario, but we can control our panic responses. The Lone Star Tick is named for the white spot on its back that some say resemble a star, but we guess we fail that Rorschach test because it looks more like a blob. These ticks are indigenous to the eastern United States and Mexico. One bite from one of these ticks can cause you to develop a meat allergy. Sounds crazy, but it's true. These ticks can mess with your immune system and cause an alpha gel allergy, making you allergic to the sugars found in meats other than poultry or fish. Allergic reactions can vary from annoying hives and rashes to trouble breathing, which can be ultimately fatal. Another unsettling part of this whole thing is that scientists aren't sure how exactly the Lone Star ticks are triggering this response in humans, and that it tends to affect people regardless of their genetic makeup. It's kind of disturbing to think that one tiny bite from a tick could mean that you'll never enjoy a bite of bacon again. The producer of the most painful insect sting is the bullet ant. It's so bad that victims have likened the sensation to being shot, hence the ant's name. If you're stung, you can expect a full 24 hours of throbbing waves of all-consuming pain. Not a great way to spend a summer day. This summer, be sure to take plenty of precautions to avoid ending up in a painful predicament. Which one of these insects would you be most scared to encounter in the wild? Tell us which one gave you the heebie-jeebies in the comment section. Don't forget to please like our video, and we'll see you next time.